Shivanand Sharma Memorial RV College video lecture. This is an ISR initiative. SSMRV College, one of the premier institutes run by the prestigious RV group of institutions, has come up with a unique initiative to engage students at the time of this unforeseen medical emergency caused by corona outbreak. As a socially responsible institution, we would like to connect academically with the students to make good the losses caused. In this connection, I, Shobha BG of Department of Commerce, has posted a video on the subjects cost management and performance management, and the topic covered is budgetary control. Please watch the video till the end and like, share with your peer groups and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you. This video is exclusively made to cover the syllabus for 6th semester BCom elective subject cost management and performance management. This is a common topic in accounting and finance electives. Topics to be enlightened: meaning and definition of budget, objectives of budgeting, meaning and definition of budgetary control, objectives of budgetary control, advantages of budgetary control, limitations of budgetary control, then types of budget, cash budget, fixed and flexible budget, and lastly master budget. As we all know that budget is an important tool in the hands of management, which is going to decide the success of an organization. So let us understand what is the definition of budget. According to CIMA, that is Chartered Institute of Management Accountants, UK, a budget is a plan quantified in monetary terms, prepared and approved prior to a defined period of time, usually showing planned income to be generated and expenditure to be incurred during the period and the capital to be employed to attain a given objective. It means a budget is always shown in a monetary term, that is in a quantified term, and it is going to be approved before its implementation, and budget is always prepared for a definite period of time, and it is going to show us the total income to be generated and the expenditure which is going to be incurred. To conclude, budget is going to help us to find out what is the capital to be employed on the business to attain a given objective. To conclude the definition, we can make out the following characteristics of a budget. First one, it is mainly a forecasting and controlling device. Second one, it is prepared in advance before the actual operation of the company or a project. Third one, it is in connection with a definite future period. Fourth one, before implementation, it is to be approved by the management. And last one is, it also shows the capital to be employed during the period. So to conclude, we can say that budget is an estimating device, and it is always prepared in advance, and it is prepared for the future period. Then it is going to be approved by the top level management, and last one, it shows the capital to be employed during the period. Let us discuss what are the objectives or purposes of adopting a budget in the organization. The budgets are going to help in the different areas, that is in the field of planning, coordination, setting the targets, motivation, anticipating capital requirements, and last one, fixing the responsibilities. So by looking at all these objectives, we can make out that the budgets are going to give a guidelines with regarding to the planning part, means for each department, what is the future course of action. For example, if it is a purchasing department, what is the quantity of raw material required? Or if it is a human resource department, what are the number of labors required, or how many skilled and unskilled workers are required? Then the second area of application is the coordination. Budget is going to bring a proper coordination between the different departments, because when the production department makes a budget estimation, that is, what is the quantity of production required, then it should have a proper coordination between the purchase department, because the raw materials are supplied by the purchase department to the production department. And third objective is the setting the targets. Each department will be given a target. If it is a production department, what is the quantity of raw material to be produced? If it is a human resource department, what is the minimum number of labors to be required to complete the given target? Or if it is a finance department, what is the money they are going to spend for the given activity? Then the fourth objective is the motivation. When the standards are going to be set, or when the estimations are made, so the estimations always will be the motivation for each of the department, because they have to achieve the given target. Fifth one is anticipating the capital requirements. After preparing the budgets, we are going to find out what is the number of workers required, what is the amount we are going to spend on the labor cost, and how much is the material required, what is the amount we are going to spend for the material, and also the expenses that we are going to incur for it. And last one is the fixing the responsibilities. After making a budget, each department will be made responsible for the given target which they have to achieve it. Once the budgets are prepared, it is very essential to exercise control on the prepared budgets. So let us understand what is budgetary control. According to CIMA, budgetary control is the establishment of budgets relating to the responsibilities of executives of a policy and the continuous comparison of the actual with the budgeted results, either to secure by individual action the objectives of the policy or to provide a basis for its revision. It means budgetary control is going to help us to set the responsibilities, then compare the actual with the estimated and find out the deviations, and also help us to make a revisions if required found. And following are the other features which we can make out by studying this definition. The first feature of budgetary control is establishment of budgets for each purpose of the business. Second one is revision of budget in a view of changes in the conditions. Third one, comparison of actual performance with the budget on a continuous basis. Fourth one, taking suitable remedial action whenever necessary. And last one is analysis of variations of actual performance from that of the budgeted performance to know the reasons thereof. So with all these features, what we are going to conclude is that budgetary control provides or helps us to compare the actual work or the actual result with the estimated or the budgeted results, and finding the variations. If the variations are found negative, means not favorable to the organizations, remedial actions are going to be taken. So budget provides us a basis to make any correction in our future activities. Following are the objectives of budgetary control. First, planning. Second, coordination. Third, measurement of success. Fourth one, motivation. Fifth one, control. Advantages of budgetary control. First advantage is the budgetary control helps us to conduct the business in most professional manner. Second, help, it ensures the teamwork. Third one, it increases the production efficiency and eliminates the unwanted wastes. Next, budgeting also helps in obtaining the bank credits. Next, it reviews the present situation and pinpoints the changes which are necessary. Budgetary control also helps to the management in planning, coordinating and controlling. And last one, many of the credit agencies look the budgetary control as a sound management tool. Let us discuss the limitations of budgetary control. The first limitation is, once the budgets are set, the work should not deviate from the set goals. So it will not bring a flexibility in the operations. Second one is, it is expensive and it is beyond the capacity of the small undertaking. The next one is, the budgetary control cannot take the position of the management itself. The management team has to be present to take care of the budgets. Next one is, installation of budgetary control may be a tedious and may not be viable for the small companies. The last one is, it may bring a conflicts among the managers who may not agree with the budget targets. Classification of budgets. The budgets are classified on three bases. One is on the basis of function, next is on the basis of flexibility, third one is on the basis of time. So let us discuss the classification of budgets on the basis of the function or the department where they are prepared. First one is a sales budget, which gives the estimation about the number of or the quantity of goods to be sold in a different locality. Production budget gives a detail about the quantity of goods that they are going to produce in a given period of time. Raw material budget gives a detailed description about the quantity and the quality of material that they require. Purchase budget is going to be prepared by the purchase department, giving a description about the quantity and category of and also the cost of material bought for the production department. Labor budget estimates the different kind of labor required for the production, that is skilled, unskilled or the supervisor workers required to meet the production. Production overhead department prepares a budget which is called as a production overhead budget, which gives the details about the production cost. Selling and distribution budget gives the details about the selling cost as well as the distribution cost. Administration cost budget gives a detail about the overall cost incurred on the entire business, which are all of indirect in nature. Next one is a capital expenditure budget, which gives a detailed information about the capital investments, means the long-term investment. It can be a buying of machinery, a starting a new branch, or major investment which are capital in nature. Then last one is a cash budget, which is going to be discussed in detail in the next slides. Next one is classification on the basis of the flexibility. So first category is a fixed budget, next one is a flexible budget. It happens in some of the organization that the production is going to be the uniform all the time. So those kind of business organization can go with a fixed budget where there will not be deviation either in the production or in the cost. But usually it may not happen. That's the reason there is another category which is called as a flexible budget, which provides a scope for any kind of changes either in the output or in the expenditure. Then third category is budget on the basis of the time or the duration or the time required to implement the budget. First one is a long-term budget, usually which is prepared for 5 to 10 years. Then the next one is a short-term budget, which is for the period of 1 to 5 years. Hope all of you understood what is a budget, what is a budgetary control, and what are the types of budget. Let us discuss in detail about the cash budget and flexible budget, because on these budgets we will be working out the problems. So let us start with the cash budget. So cash budget is nothing but it is a projection of the cash receipts from all the sources and the cash payment for all the purposes. So as to understand what is our liquidity position or what is our working capital position. Here is a format for the cash budget. You can find that there are four columns. One is a particulars, then you can find 3 months like Jan, Feb and March as an example. In the particulars column, you can see there is an opening balance, all the receipts are added and all the payments are deducted. And at the end, that from the total receipts, if you deduct the payment, you are going to get the closing balance. You can find out that all the another important type of budget is a flexible budget. Flexible budget is one which is designed to change in relation to the level of activity attained. This budget is more practical and more sensible budget, because as we know that we will not be producing the same quantity of goods all the time. So always the production depends on the requirement or on customer demand. So based on customer demand, the production is going to happen. So there will be a chances of changes in the quantity of goods produced. So keeping this objective into mind, the flexible budget is designed. So it helps us to make an estimation for the different level of activities. Here is a format for the flexible budget. You can find there are four columns. One is a particulars column, then three columns stating the different level of activity. Means if the machine capacity is 100%, so we may not be producing the 100% capacity, or may not be using the 100% capacity of the machine, because there may not be a demand for the 100% capacity of the machine. So there can be the 70% or 80% or 90% depending on the demand. So in this format, in the particulars column, you can find out that there is a list of expenses incurred. So there are different formats used for preparing a flexible budget. Some of the textbook, they use the format like stating all the variable expenses in the beginning, then next all the fixed expenses, then finding the total cost, then finding the profit, then last the sales. But here in this slide, you can find the format, flexible budget format, in the cost sheet format, because in the beginning there is a prime cost listed which shows all the direct expenses, then all the variable expenses, then next comes the total of variable expenses, then the sales, then the contribution, fixed cost, then fixed factory overheads, admin overhead, selling and distribution overhead, total cost, and last profit or loss. Master budget. Master budget is a review budget which combines all the functional budgets, and it may take the form of financial statements at the end of the budget period. It is also called the operating budget. So we can conclude that master budget integrates all the different department budget. Hope all of you understood. Any doubts, most welcome. Thank you. Thank you for watching the video.